Oh, bloody hell, that is heinous.
An acquired taste, certainly.
So, if we're tripping balls, how do we know to take the nectar?
Always been with us. Through all the famines, the hunger of the starving masses gave the spirit strength. Nothing could satisfy the demon's appetite. After consuming a body, it moved on to the next, leaving a growing trail of death. The shaman couldn't sit by and watch his people starve. He could see what no one else could. This was the evil work of a dark spirit. He faced an impossible choice. For they were all his children. There was only one way to stop it. The demon was invited to enter the boy whom the shaman offered as a sacrifice. The sacred kusa knife, used for the scarification, passed down by generations of shaman. Centuries of powerful magic contained within. The tongue had to be removed, so the shaman could not be cursed for what he did. The pattern. To be precise. Nimoth couldn't resist the offering. Upon entering the boy, he began consuming him. But as the demon was now trapped by the containment markings the shaman left, knowing it would ultimately consume the boy and itself.
Plan. Shame it didn't stick. I mean, what are the odds the kid lands himself in the one bloody alley that Gary Lester stumbles into?
Take it slowly, my friend.
Don't worry, mate. It's not my first disco.